Shoot che ma. Which meant, what's the big deal? That's what my father used to say. I was about 24 years old, working in New York City. It was a high-paying job, my first job. I asked my boss, I said, it's been 15 long months since I've seen my family. Can I get a 5-week vacation? Nope. I quit that day. I spent rest of the week shopping. And next week, I was on the plane. I had 2 large suitcases filled with gifts for my family. I was heading home. I was that guy on the plane who really wants to kind of get out of the plane before the plane stops. I was that excited guy. And when I saw my family, there were hugs, cheers, and laughter. It was all just happiness. My mother had tears in her eyes. And then when I met my father said, "Welcome home." It was the same firm handshake. I was back home now. Nostalgia took over. I was in the same room, the same bed, doing every single thing that I used to do before, which was nothing. Nothing at all. And so, I can never forget this time when my father walked into my room. His tall figure, I could see the shadow. It was about 8:45 in the morning, and we were in a tall building. It was an 8-story tall building, and we were on the 2nd floor. He walks in, and I knew that he was gonna yell at me. And he's gonna say, "Get out of the bed, it's 8:45. Instead, he put a warm comforter over my body. I pretended that I was still sleeping. He closed the curtains, and then he walked away. It was weird. I was like, why is he doing this? About a minute later, I hear the sound of rumble. It's coming from my left side. Window was on the left. I couldn't quite make out what it was. Before I could think, our building started to shake. This is when I look up. I look up and I see dangling ceiling fan. I knew it was an earthquake. I wanted to get out of the bed and dash right towards the door. But before I could complete my thought, everything inside the building started to shake and rattle, go up and down, up and down. This was not a roller coaster motion. This was a rattling, fierce motion which was breaking everything apart, 6 to 8 inches up and down, up and down. I had no control over my body. I couldn't do anything. I wanted to get out, but I couldn't get even out of my bed. Everything in the room, including furniture, heavy stuff around me, was becoming airborne. And then, once again, I look up and I see a 6 to 8 inch wide crack go across the room, and I could see the rods pulling apart. And that is when I knew that the building was going to fall, but once again, I couldn't complete my thought, and our building came crashing down. As I mentioned, we were on the 2nd floor. I had 6 floors above me. It came crashing down, and then the building fell sideways. I was trapped. I was trapped in a space which is less than what you find in a coffin. It continued to shake for the next 2 minutes. 2 minutes of rattling motion continued. It felt as if a monster was going to come out of the earth's crust and consume our building. And then there was silence. Absolute silence. As if nothing had happened. So I knew that it was a bad dream. So I went back to sleep. It had to be a dream. 1 minute later, I wake up. It was real. I shouted, Not even an insect knew that I was fighting for my life. I was disconnected from the rest of the world. I couldn't do anything. The only thing I had was the glowing light, the shining light from my wristwatch, this one. It was a guiding light which helped me to know what time it was, what day it was, what hour it was. During the next few hours, I continued to shout. I knew it was not working, so I had to save my energy. As time passed, I became thirsty. My tongue felt like a piece of wood. I became hungry. This portion of your body, you know, this is where you feel hunger. It burned for hours and hours and hours. What's the big deal? Shuchema. That's the voice that came in my head. That was my father's voice. He always used to say that. And so I thought about food that I hated the most. Eggplant. Eggplant pulp. Put in a clawfoot bathtub. Rodents going in and out. Fungus. Filthy stuff. And then I asked myself, are you hungry now? Mm-mm. Nope. Thirst was a different thing. I stayed in the same position for a long time. The third day, I drank my own urine. The following day, I drank my own recycled urine. It looked similar to what you guys were having back there. But I'm telling you, it's delicious. And so, the rescuers were looking and finding only bodies. It was the fifth day. When they pulled me out, there was no scratch on me. I was called a miracle. While I was inside, I knew one thing, that my father must have gotten everyone out. He was a strong man. He had seen disasters and he had always come out. And he was someone who would not even talk about it. He would just scratch his beard and change the topic. He was a very strong man. But once I came out, I learned that my family has not yet been found. So I knew that my father was somewhere inside struggling. I just knew it. When I was inside, I thought that my father was probably having a shoulder around my mother, having his hand around my mother's shoulder and saying, hey, your son is going to be okay. But now I was here outside looking for them. So I wasn't sure about everyone else, but I knew that my father was going to make it. The next day, I found my brother. The following day, I found my sister-in-law and my two-year-old nephew. 2 days that followed, during that time, I found my mother and my father. None of them survived. It was over. Shuchema! What's the big deal? So I chose to stand back up. I stood up and I walked again. 8 months later, I returned to the US to complete my master's degree. It was a dream that my parents had for me. It was a collective dream that we all had. As time followed, I fell down a million times, but I stood back up. I'm standing, right? I stood back up. Life is a beautiful thing if you are alive. and living. And every single time that I fell down, I felt that I wouldn't be able to get back up again. And then I only heard this voice inside. It said, "Shoot, Emma, what's the big deal?" And there was one more thing I heard. It said, "Solid Revanu," which meant stay strong. Thanks, guys.